How are you doing, Shaggy?
Well, I'm doing good. Thank you for taking my name correct this time.
I was hoping you won't bring that up.
Yeah, I'm certain you put in a lot of practice into that.
Okay, so today we're gonna talk about trauma. Let's start the conversation. Okay.
Just right away?
Yeah, right away.
Okay.
So there's a lot of like misconception about trauma. I believe a lot of people think that trauma is just like if something really bad happens to you, like if you're in a car accident or like if you lose a loved one. Is that really what trauma is?
To understand trauma, what we need to understand first is that trauma in itself is very subjective. Say it. Subjective, what does subjective mean? Subjective होने से क्या मतलब है? It basically means is के any event that is too stressful for you to cope with it can be trauma. Say it. For example, for me, let's just give you an example. Both of us are going and हम दोनों का जो है कहते हैं both of us experience a car accident. सही है. Car accident could be a traumatic event for me and on the same hand उसी उसके अंदर क्या कहते हैं it wouldn't be a traumatic experience for you. So because the way you perceive that event. So you see the difference. हम दोनों एक ही चीज से गुजरे but some that was traumatic for me and it wasn't traumatic for you. यहाँ पे this is what subjectivity means. So trauma could be anything. Which is too stressful for a person to cope up with. किसी बच्चे के लिए एग्जाम में फेल होना could be a traumatic experience as well. सही है? Now that you think of it and you look at it कि यार स्कूल में एग्जाम में फेल हो गया, it's not the end of the world. If I मतलब for me it's going to be like this. But there are some people you know जो जिनके marks कम आ जाते हैं. For example they're not even feeling and I'm like यार तुम pass तो हो गए हो, तुम फिर भी क्यों इतना रो रहे हो, क्यों इतना जो है why are you so upset about it? Because for that person that is very traumatic. सही है? He is not able to cope with the stress. He or she would not be able to cope with the stress. That's why it's traumatic for him. So trauma it could be anything. ज़रूरी नहीं है कि कोई car accident हो, किसी you know close one की death हो या anything like that. It could be any event whatsoever.
So what you're saying is anything that's stressful for you is your trauma.
Anything is stress. We do have stress in our lives, but stress that becomes unmanageable or too much in easier language. That could lead towards trauma. Again, that for certainty we can't say it for sure.
Mm-hmm.
But that stress that's too much to cope up with can lead to trauma.
So is there just this one type of trauma? Is that what trauma is?
No, there are different types of trauma. There are two broad categories of trauma. Your question is are there more types of trauma?
Yeah.
So do हमारे पास जो है कहते we have two types of trauma. Number one for our audience is shock trauma, and the number second is developmental trauma. So basically the difference between them is shock trauma, जैसे मैंने अभी आपको example दी car accident वाले.
Car accident, death of loved one.
Yeah, yeah. कि किस कोई ऐसा event हुआ जिसके अंदर too much is happening too fast and too sudden. सही है?
Oh, too much is happening too fast.
Too much is happening too fast too sudden. तो एक साथ बहुत सारी चीजें होनी हैं. That is so overwhelming for you and that is you know so stressful for you that you experience it as a trauma. सही है? So that is shock trauma, जैसे हमने गाड़ी example ली, car accident example ली. On the other hand, developmental trauma is a trauma that you go through for a persistent amount of time.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, it does not happen overnight. Okay. For example, you can take an example of people who do not live in a healthy environment, या victims of multiple sexual abuse. सही है. तो इस तरह से क्या होता है कि they are developing into that trauma. कि for example when they were 5 years old and they experienced some sort of abuse, could be physical abuse की बात कर लेते हैं. कुछ households ऐसे होते हैं जहाँ पर उनका environment इस तरह का नहीं होता and they do go through physical abuse. तो ऐसा तो नहीं है ना कि एक बार हुआ तो खत्म हो गया. It is something that happens you know over a period of time. तो when the kid is growing up, at that time he is not aware what's happening. But what's actually happening is that kid is going through the developmental trauma. As the person is developing, so is the trauma.
Okay, so as they grow up, if they go through a stressful traumatic thing, that is developmental trauma. So like a child abuse is still pretty extreme, I would say.
Mm-hmm.
Are there any you know lighter experiences that might develop into? Like, for example, neglect for parents.
Exactly, this is what I was coming up to. When you say child abuse is something that's very extreme, I don't agree with this because जब हम चाइल्ड अब्यूज का नाम लेते हैं तो हमारे जहन में एक फिजिकल या सेक्सुअल अब्यूज की बात आती है, बट देयर इज अनदर अब्यूज दैट्स यू नो वेरी ऑफन लुक्ड अवे, व्हिच इज इमोशनल अब्यूज. Now that's another a vast topic. क्या उसके ऊपर we can do you know another live session about on emotional abuse and what emotional trauma is. तो लेकिन to give a gist of it, emotional abuse could be any abuse की जहाँ पे there is too much or too less of emotion involved. For example, yeah, it goes both ways, too much and too less. For example, you are a child and you are facing emotional abuse by your parents. That could be that could also be that you your parents are always on your case, they're always like yahan nahi jana, you know, they're always loving you too much, they're always giving you extra attention that you become too much dependent upon them. And unke bagair you can't even, you know, take a step outside of your house. Ek certain age tak sahi hota hai, 3-4 saal, 5 saal ki umar tak, you know, you need that dependency. But at some point you need your independence because that helps you to grow. So too much of emotion is also not good. इसी तरह से नेग्लिजेंस ऑफ इमोशन इज ऑल्सो यू नो सेम लाइक दैट, क्योंकि उसके अंदर क्या हो रहा है कि यू आर नॉट गेटिंग द नर्चरिंग दैट यू सपोज टू गेट. एवरी चाइल्ड, जब भी कोई बच्चा पैदा होता है, देयर आर सम बायोलॉजिकल एंड फिजिकल एंड इमोशनल नीड्स दैट आर सपोज टू बी देयर. अगर वो कम होगी या वो बहुत ज्यादा होगी, दैट इज गोइंग टू अफेक्ट द पर्सन एंड दैट कैन ऑल्सो लीड टू ट्रॉमा. सो कमिंग बैक टू योर क्वेश्चन, कि चाइल्ड अब्यूज, तो व्हाट वाज योर क्वेश्चन अबाउट चाइल्ड अब्यूज?
आई वाज सेइंग चाइल्ड अब्यूज इज स्टिल
Yeah, so I was saying that emotional abuse also comes under child abuse, and that is something that happens, you know, very, on a very widespread scale.
Okay, so okay, if we talk about trauma, a lot of people don't like to talk about it, right?
Don't like trauma.
Yeah. So then, how do they kind of like deal with it?
Unfortunately, in the society that we live in, we are based in Pakistan. पाकिस्तान के अंदर जो है एट दिस पॉइंट देयर इज नॉट मच अवेयरनेस. ट्रॉमा तो दूर की बात है, साइकोलॉजिकल हेल्थ की भी अवेयरनेस नहीं है, मेंटल हेल्थ की भी अवेयरनेस नहीं है. सो ट्रॉमा इज समथिंग दैट कम्स यू नो वे आफ्टर दैट, एटलीस्ट इन पीपल्स माइंड, एटलीस्ट इन पीपल्स माइंड. तो दिस इज अगेन अ वेरी ब्रॉड टॉपिक कि हाउ टू क्रिएट अवेयरनेस एंड हाउ टू यू नो ब्रिंग पीपल टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाट ट्रॉमा रियली इज. दिस इज पार्ट ऑफ द रीजन व्हाई वी आर डूइंग दिस. तो द थिंग इज कि जो है क्या कहते हैं, वी नीड टू रीच आउट टू मोर पीपल एंड वी नीड टू टेल देम कि ट्रॉमा इज नॉट, हम जब फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू आस्क समवन, कोई लेमैन है आप उससे पूछेंगे व्हाट इज ट्रॉमा, लेमैन भी नहीं, अगर किसी अच्छे यू नो नॉलेजेबल इंसान से भी आप बात करें तो इन देयर माइंड ट्रॉमा इज कि यार अच्छा वो उसका जो है कि किसी क्लोज वन की डेथ हो गई या उसके जो है एक्सीडेंट हो गया, तो दैट पर्सन इज अ ट्रॉमा. Trauma is not just that, sir. And your question was how to address.
Like a lot of people don't want to talk about it.
Don't
want
to talk about.
How do they deal with trauma if they don't want to talk about it?
Again, we need to make them realize the importance of talking about trauma. Sir, we need whenever we talk about trauma, ये एक general perception है कि it's all about the mind. Sir, कि it's all मतलब कि क्या कहते हैं, trauma is in the mind. You even the people who seek therapy and
yeah, because I've come across a lot of people who have, you know, taken therapy and all those things, but still they're like, no.
Yeah, exactly, exactly.
It doesn't work.
So isme jo lacking aati hai, and what people need to understand is, and therapists, there are good therapists who know this, but there are a lot of people who don't even know this, is ke mind is only the half of what trauma is. क्या मतलब हुआ इस बात का, टू एक्सप्लेन दिस इज के व्हेन यू से व्हेन अ पर्सन गोज थ्रू ट्रॉमा एंड दैट पर्सन सीक्स हेल्प और सीक थेरेपी, तो व्हेन दे आर डूइंग दैट, व्हेन दे आर सीकिंग द थेरेपी, दे आर ओनली टॉकिंग एंड रीलिविंग द ट्रॉमा. सही है, रीलिविंग द ट्रॉमा कैन ऑल्सो बी रीट्रॉमाटाइजिंग. सही है, बिकॉज दे आर यू नो ऑलवेज टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट एंड दे आर ओनली टेकिंग इन टू द अकाउंट द माइंड पार्ट ऑफ द ट्रॉमा. देर इज अनदर पार्ट टू इट, देर इज mind and there's body. So what happens is ke whenever you're going to through a traumatic incident, and whenever you have gone through a traumatic incident, that trauma has an impact on your mind, that's a given.
Yeah.
But it also has an impact on your body. How your body reacted to that trauma is also very important, and how to there's a book called The Body Keeps the Score. and Waking the Tiger by Peter Levine. So, you know, Peter Levine says that mind is only the half of it, and the body is also, you know, as important as treating the mind. So you need to work both ways. So, you know, there's that.
What do you mean by working on the body?
Working on the body. So there are certain things that you could do. Okay, the philosophy is that trauma is stored in the body. So yeah, the idea behind it is that the trauma is stored in the body, and one of the way you can, you know, work on these bodily symptoms is by releasing the trauma that's stored in the body through different exercises or through different, you know, somatic, I am forgetting the name, something somatic. So, क्या कहते हैं, for example, an exercise to release the trauma is a trauma release exercise which we do here as well. I think we do it every Saturday or every Tuesday, yeah. So, we do have trauma release exercises here at our tech center as well. And the whole purpose of that TRE, trauma release exercise, is to, you know, release the trauma that's already stored in our body. Because the mind part, we do it. Even if you don't go to a therapist or anything like that, we talk to our friends, we talk to our family. कहीं ना कहीं वो एड्रेस हो रहा होता है, बट द बॉडी पार्ट, आई डोंट थिंक सो. सो या
Talking will come only when you know you're kind of like accepting or you are aware of your trauma.
या
Sometimes what happens is you don't even know that something happened.
something has happened,
Something
something
has
is affecting
happened
you.
because like maybe you don't have the memory of it, or maybe because you don't wanna think about it. What do you do with such?
So the thing is कि I had a client and I was seeing the client, and उसमें ये था कि a person brought his child, 5-year-old child, and the presenting of him was that this the kid is having nightmares. सही है, एंड उसे जो है ना उसको डरावनी ख्वाब आते हैं, डरावनी ख्वाब आके वो सो सो जाता है. तो जो है क्या कहते हैं, एंड दैट पर्सन वाज लाइक कि जो अब्बा थे उनको ये लग रहा था कि ये ड्रामे हो रहे हैं, या बस आप इसको देख लें कि क्यों इतना जो है ये डरता है डरता है. तो बट वॉट ही फेल टू रियलाइज वॉज कि इट्स नॉट जस्ट अ नाइटमेयर, इट्स अ ट्रामा दैट किड इज गोइंग थ्रू, एंड दैट ट्रामा इज मैनिफेस्टिंग इन द फॉर्म ऑफ नाइटमेयर्स. सही है. तो मेनी टाइम्स व्हाट हैपेंस इज कि जो है क्या कहते हैं, यू यू माइट बी एक्सपीरियंसिंग सिम्टम्स जिसके लिए पॉसिबल प्लॉजिबल कोई एक्सप्लेनेशन नहीं होगी. सही है,
because you're not aware of the
एग्जैक्टली,
thing that
या. सो यू यू वोंट हैव अ प्लॉजिबल एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ व्हाई इट्स हैपनिंग. इट्स वेरी मच पॉसिबल दैट इट्स सम काइंड ऑफ ट्रॉमा दैट्स, यू नो, सप्रेस्ड इन योर मेमोरी एंड सप्रेस्ड इन योर माइंड एंड इन योर बॉडी, दैट्स रिफ्लेक्टिंग इन योर प्रेजेंट लाइफ. एंड दैट ब्रिंग्स टू अ टॉपिक, ट्रॉमा इन द प्रेजेंट. The topic that we're talking about is how this trauma comes and affects our present. This is one way that it does. Because if there's unaddressed trauma, इसकी एक और एग्जाम्पल इस तरह से हो सकती है कि when you're a child, if you go through a, you know, medical procedure or anything like that, or उसमें when you're in anesthesia, there are children जो that being in the hospital and being in the treatment is very traumatic for them, but they don't realize it. Only after, you know, 10 years, 15 years, when they grow up, they start to experience symptoms, and normally इनके साथ कुछ हुआ नहीं होता. सही है, they think back of it, they can't remember anything, but it's the trauma of the surgery that they don't remember, that's suppressed in their mind, which is reflecting and which is, you know, कहते हैं, having an impact on their present life. इसकी example जो है in the book of Peter Levine, Waking the Tiger, उसमें उसने ये example दी थी कि एक लड़की थी, she was having, you know, panic attacks. सही है, और बहुत ज़्यादा उसको पैनिक अटैक हो रहे थे, एंड देर वॉज क्या कहते हैं उसको कोई स्पेसिफिक सिम्टम किसी और चीज़ का नहीं था, मतलब कोई और कॉज समझ नहीं आ रहा था. एंड ड्यूरिंग द थेरेपी दे रियलाइज दैट इट वॉज हैपनिंग बिकॉज ऑफ द ट्रॉमा दैट दैट चाइल्ड दैट दैट पर्सन हैज एक्सपीरियंस एज अ चाइल्ड व्हेन शी वॉज इन हॉस्पिटल गोइंग थ्रू अ सर्जरी, एंड दैट सर्जरी वॉज इफेक्टिंग हर प्रेजेंट, क्योंकि उसका जो है पैनिक अटैक्स आ रहे थे. And as soon as they realized it and they did some, you know, trauma relief exercises and क्या कहते हैं, they did the exercises to release the trauma from the mind and from the body as well. And when it came into her consciousness, that started to heal her, and eventually she went on to college and graduating with a doctorate degree without having a relapse. So, you know, it's as
So
important.
you're saying that it's possible if someone has a body ache or like a somatic complaint,
Yeah.
it could be
It could.
because of a trauma and not there
Yeah.
might not be a medical explanation for
Exactly.
it.
Exactly. कभी कभी ऐसा होता है कि जो है ना, यू आर हैविंग सम मेडिकल प्रॉब्लम्स और उसका जो है यू गो एंड हैव एक्सरेज और आप जो अपना ब्लड टेस्ट करा रहे हैं एंड एवरीथिंग इज कमिंग आउट नॉर्मल फिजिकली फिजियोलॉजिकली देयर इज नथिंग रॉन्ग विद यू बट व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इज दैट द बॉडी इज कीपिंग स्कोर द बॉडी कीप द स्कोर दैट इज मैनिफेस्टिंग इन योर करंट लाइफ एंड दैट इज गिविंग यू यू नो द सोमैटिक कंप्लेंट्स दैट यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट
So people should, you know, focus on it. I'm not saying that talk therapy does not work. Really.
Yeah, no, I'm not saying that talk therapy does not work. I'm saying that that's just a half of it.
So, like, talk therapy can work, but you also need to work on your body too, if you really want to release the trauma.
Interesting. They go like hand in glove. Mind and body go hand in glove. If you're beating the mind, you should also you know, focus on getting your body treated as well.
So, okay, I have a question. Like you said, trauma can be anything that's like really stressful for you.
Yeah.
So does that mean that all of us are going through post-traumatic
stress disorder?
Are we all going through that?
If it's affecting you, dekho, at some point, every one of us had gone through trauma or
mm-hmm.
is going to go through trauma or are going through trauma.
Yeah.
So,
and not everyone has addressed it.
And not everyone has addressed it, but. What makes us, you know, function every day and हमें पता नहीं चलता कि something is going on with us is because our body has three coping responses towards any type of trauma. सही है? तो whenever ये एक natural phenomena है, it all happens naturally. तो whenever you are experiencing through trauma or you're going through a traumatic experience, there are three ways your body react, body and mind react. Number one is fight. Number two is flight and freeze. These are the three classic responses that your body and mind have towards a traumatic experience. Fight, flight and freeze. Abhi hote kya? Yeah, fight, flight and freeze. Ye hote kya? So basically, jab aapke saath koi traumatic event hota hai, aapki body ya to us event ke liye, you know, you feel ki agar is tarah ka event hone wala hai, you just take a step back and you run away from it. Or you, you know, go away from that place. That is flight. You're going away. Fight is something that you know actively take part and you know fight a traumatic experience. We'll go into example later. And freeze is basically that your mind and your body just you know freezes. So yeah, you just get stuck.
So
your body disassociates.
Literally freezing or is it like you know just getting lost in your thoughts or something like?
Both. I'll give you examples. I'll give you examples. It could happen in both the way, like literally freezing. Or you know your mind and body mind wandering at some other thing. So we'll go into the examples. For example, एक आदमी है गाड़ी चला रहा है. Personal example. Going through I was driving and I had a car accident. सही है? That was around 5-6 years ago. तो जब मैं गाड़ी चला रहा था, गाड़ी चलाते चलाते the moment before my car the other car hit my car, I knew that it's going to hit. And there is nothing that I could do about it. I knew that the trauma is going to come through me. I did not know it at that point. Like it was like it's too late to do anything now. So my body, what my body did was I just froze. I just froze. I was like, I was driving and I did not hit the brake. I did not do anything. I was just, you know, just there stuck. Why did that happen? We'll come back to that later. There is another response. Flight response. You are going towards through a traumatic experience. For example, you are out on the street and you see someone shooting someone. So what you do is you run away from that situation. That's flight. That's your body response of coping with that situation. Usi situation ke andar you see that someone is pulling out a gun on someone else and you're like no I want to do something. So you go and fight that person. So yeah, you go and stop that person. That's your or you sab kuch what we need to remember is ye sab kuch involuntary ho raha. So yeah, it's happening naturally.
Because when you said ki if you see someone taking out a gun, some of us might freeze.
Yeah, that's your that would be your bodily response.
Yeah.
So yeah, you might freeze.
Some of us might run and
yeah, some of us yeah might fight. So this is how your body reacts in three different ways. So yeah. So acha, iske liye ek aur interesting fact matlab wo ye hai ki why does our body freezes or why do we run away? So at that point जब वो event हो रहा होता है ये जो हम सब बात करें this is like the example of shock trauma क्योंकि too much is happening all of a sudden सही है एक साथ हो रहा है यही तीनों response हमारे पास developmental trauma में हो सकते हैं we'll talk about that later सही है तो what happens is कि जो है क्या कहते हैं हम when you are going through that experience or जो है क्या कहते हैं you feel के someone is pulling out a gun on you, you why do you freeze? Because you know that it's too late. Your body processes in the way के nothing can be done now and in that moment your body and your mind is programmed in a way कि you won't feel the pain.
आपने like numbness.
सही है आपने अक्सर आकाश सुना होगा जिन लोगों का एक्सीडेंट होता है या यू नो व्हेन व्हेन दे व्हेन दे डू रिकवर दे लाइक के यू नो मैं जा रहा था एंड देन आई डोंट रिमेम्बर व्हाट हैपेंड
सो यू सेइंग कि व्हेन
यू फ्रीज यू योर बॉडी डिसोसिएट्स सही है एंड व्हाई डज इट हैपन इज टू अवॉइड द पेन दैट्स गोइंग टू हैपन सो यू आर नॉट
इवन गोइंग टू
हैव द मेमोरी या मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम यू डोंट बट इट्स स्टोर्ड इन योर बॉडी इट्स स्टोर्ड इन योर बॉडी सही है इट्स स्टोर्ड इन योर बॉडी एंड समवेयर स्टोर्ड इन योर अनकॉन्शियस इसकी एग्जांपल उसी तरह से है कि इफ यू वॉच नेशनल ज्योग्राफिक एक डियर है हिरन है वो अपना चल रहा है एंड यू नो अचीता स्टॉक्स हिम एंड ही स्टार्ट्स टू रन आफ्टर सही है एंड द मोमेंट दे द चीता कैचेस द डियर यू वुड सी दैट द डियर इज नॉट डेड द डियर इज नॉट डेड येट और इवन ही इज नॉट इंजर्ड बट ही इज जस्ट स्टिल ही इज नॉट प्रिटेंडिंग टू बी डेड His mind has made his body.
He goes into freeze.
Yeah, he goes into freeze so that when the cheetah is, you know, eating him and you know tearing him apart, he does not feel the pain. So this is how our body reacts. So this is these are the examples of shock trauma. इसी तरह से these things also happen in developmental trauma. Developmental trauma के अंदर इस तरह से होता है कि for example अगर हम abuse की बात करें, you would see people ke they are going through physical abuse by their parents or by someone older than them and they don't care they are like ek maar do aur maar lo hum bolte hain dheed ho gaya so like it does not affect them that much either that freeze or it's not affecting them that much theek hai ek to ye ho gaya iske alawa developmental trauma mein fight hua you know they would actually fight to improve the situation So yeah, you know, every time the abuse is happening, they are going to talk back. They are going to do something about it. And flight would be, you know, they would. जब भी कुछ इस तरह हो रहा है, they are going out of the house, if they can, or they are going to lock themselves in the room. So yeah, so this thing is also manifesting in the developmental trauma.
So when the person does not react, like you said,
deep in
that,
yeah.
is that freeze?
It could be freeze. Yeah. कि अच्छा मैंने जैसे यू आस्क मी कि डू वी लिटरली फ्रीज या फिर क्या कहते हैं वो फिगरेटिवली होता है दैट कुड बी बोथ सही है ज्यादातर इट्स मोर प्लॉजिबल कि यू लिटरली फ्रीज इन द शॉक ट्रॉमा ठीक है बट फॉर एग्जांपल इसके अगर हम लाइटर एग्जांपल लें एक तरह से कि एग्जाम स्ट्रेस है सही है वी हैव एग्जाम स्ट्रेस हम एक कोई स्टूडेंट उसके ऊपर एग्जाम स्ट्रेस है एग्जाम्स आ रहे हैं पढ़ाई की टेंशन है जॉब की टेंशन है एंड ऑल दैट And what that person is doing nothing about it and just, you know, wasting his time on Netflix. So what is that person doing? That person is avoiding all that and wo jo hai, he's not even thinking about it. So he's just froze at not thinking about it and he is distracting himself by watching Netflix and that is the figurative freeze that I'm talking about.
Okay. So I think we've all experienced.
Yeah.
At some point in our
So this is, I guess, the gist of what.
So you were talking about how developmental trauma may
flight.
What were you saying?
Fight, flight, and freeze.
Flight and freeze.
Yeah, we have three coping responses to that.
Okay. So
what else?
Interesting. Okay, we'll see if our audience has any questions. Do you have any questions? I guess that's it then. We'll end the session and we'll continue. We'll obviously talk about more different types of trauma, like you said,
yeah.
emotional trauma and all those other things. Okay, I would just like to tell our audience that we do offer trauma release exercises here at TRW Center, Trauma Release and Wellness Center. TRE Tuesdays, so not every Tuesday, every alternate Tuesdays we offer TRE services,
trauma release
exercises, so if you guys would like to explore that, you can always DM us, and we also offer trauma therapy, we have a lot of trauma release packages as well, so if anyone wants to know more about it, you can always DM us, and we'd be happy to help you, that's it.
Yeah,
thank
that's
you so
it.
much, Shahid, again for joining
thank you
us.
For having